Hello my dear students, welcome back to my channel. In today's session, I will discuss about two important aspects in genetics. One is multiple allelism and another is about the lethal genes. So these two we are going to discuss in detail. One I am going to discuss is about multiple alleles. The second point, second topic which I'll discuss is about the lethal genes. So let us first start with what are multiple alleles. So normally we know one gene has two alleles. One will be a dominant allele, other one will be a recessive allele. But when one gene consists of more than two alleles, then it is called as a multiple allelism. It is now called as a multiple allelism. That means if it is has more than two alleles. And these multiple alleles, the main features of multiple alleles, they occupy the same locus. They occupy the same locus in a homologous pair of chromosomes.
That means one will be for a dominant locus, other one will be for a recessive one.
I hope you know this position. So this is a homologous pair of chromosomes. Suppose one dominant allele is present in this position, which is called as a locus. In the same position, its other allele will be present. But we know at a time, two alleles occupy the same locus in a homologous pair. Suppose there are more than two alleles, but at one time, in a homologous pair, we have two alleles. But more than two alleles also, if they are present, many alleles are present, they occupy the same locus. That is called as a multiple allelism. Now, how do these arise? Multiple alleles arise due to mutation. Multiple alleles arise due to mutation. Mutation of one particular gene, the different alleles, they arise. Now let us discuss the examples. So first concept of multiple alleles was first described. It was first described in ABO blood grouping. ABO system of blood grouping. It was first described in ABO system of blood grouping. And this ABO system was of blood grouping was given first by Landsteiner. Carl Landsteiner was the first one to describe ABO system of blood grouping. So here in ABO system of blood grouping, it is controlled by three alleles. In ABO system of blood grouping, it is controlled by three alleles. And the existence of three alleles was given by Burstein, the scientist Burstein. He explained the presence of three alleles which determine the blood group. So what are those three alleles? How they are represented? IA, IB and IO. These are the three alleles which are present, and these three alleles are identified by this scientist Burstein. And the presence of AB blood group, was given by Castello, the scientist Castello and Steinick, the scientist Castello and Tiny. These two scientists described the presence of AB blood group. So now let us see what are the different alleles here and how they are present in the blood group. So we know there are three different types of alleles. So let us see what are different genotypes and phenotypes out of these three alleles. We know very well there are four different types of blood groups. We have four types of blood groups: A, B,
A, B and O. We have four types of blood groups, A, B, A, B and O. So, A blood group will have the genotype IA, IA in homozygous condition, IA and IO in heterozygous condition. And B blood group will have homozygous as IB, IB and IB, IO. AB will have only one genotype. Only one genotype, and O will have also only one genotype, that is in homozygous condition. Now let us see what is their relation. A is equal to B. Both are not, neither of the blood group, neither of the group is dominant. They are equal and both are dominant to O. A and B are considered as codominant. A and B are considered as codominant. That means if they are present together, they show codominance. None of them are dominant to each other. Both can express themselves, but both are dominant to IO. So, we get a total of here 6 genotypes, 4 phenotypes, and we get 6 genotypes. 4 phenotypes and we get 6 genotypes. 4 phenotypes and 6 genotypes. So the calculate by using the simple formula n into n plus 1 by 2. N into n plus 1 by 2, where n indicates the number of alleles, n equal to number of alleles, n equal to number of alleles. So, this is how they can be determined. So, suppose here there are 3 alleles present, we can just calculate. So, 3 into 3 plus 1 by 2, 3 plus 1 by 2. So, we get here 12 by 2, that is equal to 6 genotypes. So that's how, whatever is the number of alleles, by using this simple formula, we will be able to calculate the total number of genotypes present. That is about the multiple alleles in blood groups. So blood grouping shows two important features. One is they show multiple allelism. Another one, they also show codominance. And they show dominance. So, dominance, codominance, multiple alleles. All these three phenomena can be seen in a ABO system of blood grouping. Now, let us now go through the other examples of multiple alleles. Other examples. This was the first identified and studied with respect to multiple alleles. Let us now see the other examples. Second example. Coat color in rabbit. Coat color in rabbit is controlled by 4 alleles. Coat color in rabbit is controlled by 4 alleles. Then another example, eye color in Drosophila. Eye color in Drosophila is controlled by 15 alleles. Eye color in Drosophila is controlled by 15 alleles. And next is in case of tobacco. Tobacco self incompatibility in tobacco. This is also controlled by 4 alleles. Self incompatibility in tobacco. Self incompatibility means the self pollen will not be able to germinate on the same style. That is called as self incompatibility. This is seen with respect to one particular species of tobacco, that is called as a The species is Nicotiana elata. Nicotiana elata, not Nicotiana tubacum. Nicotiana tubacum is the common cultivated tobacco plant. So in this particular wild species of tobacco, we find there is a self-incompatibility which is controlled by four alleles. Now, the last example, wings in drosophila. Wings in drosophila is controlled by five alleles. Wings in drosophila is controlled by five alleles. So, let us list down what are all those alleles present here. So, first one, normal wings. Normal wings, we represent it as VG plus. The allele we can represent as VG plus. That is the normal wings. The second one, niched wings. Niched. VGNI. Niche. Niched wings. Niche means just a small cut. Just a small cut when it is present, that is called as a niched wings. Notched wings, the third type is called as a notched wings, VGNO, notched wings. A notch is slightly, it can be bigger compared to a niche. On the wing we can find a particular bigger notch or like say a cut or a depression, that is called as a notched wing. The third type is called as a strapped wings. Strapped wings means just a thin strap like, a flap like or a strap like, the thin structure, thin wings, that is called as a strapped wings. And the fifth type is called as vestigial wings. Fifth type is called as a vestigial wings. Vestigial means completely reduced wings, shrunken, completely reduced or shrunken wings, reduced or shrunken wings, that is called as the vestigial. So these five different types of alleles we find in case of Drosophila. So Drosophila, we know it shows many mutations also, and all the studies by Morgan, mutation studies were done in Drosophila. So it is a very important organism for all genetic studies. Okay, now let us, I complete the examples of multiple alleles. Now let us now try to discuss about lethal genes. What are lethal genes and the examples of lethal genes? Examples. So first of all, what are lethal genes? Lethal genes. Lethal means which cause death. Those are called as lethal genes. So genes which cause the death of the organism. And these lethal genes can cause death mostly in homozygous condition. They cause death in homozygous condition. This homozygous condition can be a dominant condition or it can be a recessive also. The homozygous condition can be a dominant condition or it can be a recessive condition also. Mostly the lethal mutations are recessive mutations. Rarely we find dominant condition also. So now let us see what are the different examples in case of lethal genes. So, lethal genes in animals, first example, lethal genes in animals, that is in mice, was first studied by the scientist Cunot. First studied by Cunot. Here, body color in mice. Body color in mice. So, here, yellow body color is dominant. Yellow body color is dominant and brown body color is recessive. Yellow is dominant and brown is recessive. So this yellow becomes lethal in homozygous condition. Yellow. So yellow always say we can write yellow in two genotypes. One is completely homozygous, another is heterozygous. So if it is in homozygous condition, this is lethal. That means such organisms, such animals do not survive at all. So when we observe the say F1 ratio, F1 and F2. So all F1 we can find this. So all individuals actually are only in heterozygous condition. Suppose any parent is in homozygous, this parent cannot survive. It cannot survive. It dies. So what do we find? Suppose they are yellow body color. So their genotype should be only in heterozygous condition. So suppose these two heterozygous individuals, there is a cross between two such heterozygous individuals. So next generation we are going to get, this is the genotype. We are going to get in 1:2, 2:1 ratio. These two are yellow color, yellow body color, and this is the brown body color. And but we find this will not survive. This homozygous yellow will not survive. So only these two are going to survive, heterozygous condition and homozygous, that is yellow and brown. So what is the ratio of yellow and brown? We get a ratio of yellow and brown in 2:1 condition, 2:1 ratio. So this 2:1 ratio is both, it is genotypic ratio as well as phenotypic ratio. It is both genotypic as well as phenotypic ratio. So we find a modified phenotypic ratio. So instead of 1:2, 2:1, normally when we get taking only one character, here we are going to get 2:1. So this is a modified ratio, modified 1:2, 2:1 ratio. So this condition is called as a lethal condition. Now let us take another example in case of plants. So in plants it was studied by, second example we are going to take in plants. This was studied by Bohr in snapdragon. The scientific name is Antirrhinum majus. This is the scientific name of snapdragon. And snapdragon, earlier it is discussed with respect to incomplete dominance also. That is, in case of flowers, it shows incomplete dominance, color of the flowers. Here we are taking the leaves. Here we take the leaves. So two kinds of leaves. One is golden leaves and green leaves. There are two types of leaves, golden and green. Golden is dominant, green is recessive. But in homozygous condition, these golden leaves do not survive. That means if the golden leaves are in this condition, homozygous dominant, then these do not survive. They do not survive. So therefore, always if there are golden color leaves, that means they have to be only in heterozygous condition. So when there is a breeding among heterozygous individuals, we get in next generation, we are going to get 1:2, 2:1. So this is how we will get the genotype 1:2:1. These two both will be golden leaves and this will be green leaves. But this complete homozygous will not survive. So therefore, the ratio is modified. So there is a modified ratio. There is a modified ratio of 2:1. Modified ratio of 2:1. So 2 will be golden with heterozygous condition. This is the golden with heterozygous. one will be homozygous condition. So golden to green ratio. So both phenotypic and genotypic ratio is 2:1. These are called as a modified ratios, modified F2 monohybrid ratios. Next, another example of lethal gene, we can take with respect to sickle cell anemia. Third example, sickle cell anemia. This is an example of lethal gene also. We know in sickle cell anemia, it is a genetic disorder caused by a point mutation. There is a change in single nucleotide where the normal RBCs, they change to sickle shape. And there will be oxygen deficiency in the patients who suffer from this disease. So this is caused by just replacement of one particular amino acid. Glutamic acid is replaced by valine. This I am going to discuss in detail in my next topic also, in pleiotropy, which I am going to discuss in next video. So sickle cell anemia. So sickle cell anemia, if we take, this is the genotype for normal individual. So here we are discussing about its lethality. So normal individual. Then heterozygous condition, these show mild anemia. In heterozygous condition, they show mild anemia. And completely homozygous condition, this will be lethal. So here also we find the ratio is 2:1. So this will be 1, 2 and 1. These individuals do not survive at all. So the ratio remains as 2:1, modified ratio. So sickle cell we can give under the example of even modified ratios. And lethality, we can also give sickle cell under codominance. In my earlier session, we discussed the example under codominance also. So it can be given for codominance, it can be also given for a lethal gene. So that's all for now, children. So this with this I complete the two important topics with examples, that is multiple alleles and lethal genes. In my next session, I'll be discussing in detail about pleiotropy. Pleiotropy, its examples and other important features of pleiotropy. This is all for now. Have a good day. Thank you very much, children.